fire, and ice. They make for a pretty cool theme, and they offset each other in interesting ways. I'm sure you, as well as anyone, has a preference for being hot or cold, and the Pokemon we're going to look at today have been designed to match whichever mood you're feeling. I'm a fan of the winter, and am pretty excited to discuss some of the best ice-type Pokemon out there. Today, let's focus on fire and ice. Vulpix. The Fox Pokemon. Vulpix is a small reddish-brown fox with six fluffy tails. Its name comes from Vulpes, the Latin word for fox, as well as six. Vulpix is born with a single snow-white tail that splits and gains color as it develops. These tails are gorgeous, curling, and growing more lustrous with age. Proper love from its trainer will make Vulpix a loyal companion, and it even helps its tail split and grow, but they require diligent brushing to avoid tangling. It's a very popular Pokemon due to its beautiful fur and warm and cuddly body. Inside Vulpix's body is a constantly burning blaze it uses to freely control fire and spew hot flames from its mouth. These flames can resemble deceased spirits, even being mistaken for ghosts at times. Vulpix often makes fiery orbs, similar to a Will-o'-the-Wisp, and it uses these to catch prey. During the daytime, it'll release fire to prevent overheating. When it's ready to evolve, the tails will get so hot it's like they're on fire. If attacked by strong enemies, Vulpix will pretend to be injured to trick them and escape. Vulpix is quite the cute fox. The tails and bangs really do make for a soft and cuddly Pokemon. The spooky elements to its fire are great too, and it's much more conceptually interesting that it isn't just plain old flames. Fire is paired with foxes pretty regularly in a lot of fictional media, but I can't say I've ever seen such an adorable iteration. I particularly like the ways its eyes are shaped. It's a pretty quiet and low-key Pokemon, but definitely seen as a Gen 1 darling. It doesn't stand out too much, but I love that it's here. Shiny Vulpix is another pretty bad shiny. It goes for the standard lighter coloration, but it's not very attractive and almost looks like the Vulpix went past its expiration date. In the island region of Alola, Vulpix has snow-white coats and are known as Alolan Vulpix. The Fox Pokemon. Alolan Vulpix is an ice type as opposed to fire, with a floofier, almost cloud-like tails and bangs. After many years living in the snowy Alolan Mountains, Vulpix developed power over ice and has an appearance like living snow. It exhales minus 58 degree Fahrenheit breath it uses to freeze prey solid before eating. You can see small ice particles when observing its tails up close, and it'll use them to create ice shards to cool itself off on hot days. They live together in skulks, helping each other, and when one is approached carelessly, the pack leading Ninetales will appear and freeze the culprit. The elderly sometimes refer to Alolan Vulpix as a Kyokyo, a word derived from the Hawaiian word for white. Dang. If you ask me, they topped the standard Vulpix with this design. Look at how cute and fluffy this little Vulpix is. The new all-white coloration is gorgeous, and I absolutely love its blue, almost ethereal-looking eyes. It's so much more delicate-looking too, which really ups the cuteness factor. Look at its little feet. Look at its little head poof. It's a cute. Its features are much more exaggerated compared to the standard Vulpix, with larger eyes and proportions, easily explaining why many people find it cuter, and it's a good example of how Pokemon design has changed over time. And while I like the more natural-looking Pokemon, I still really like this, and it's a fantastic regional variant. Shiny Alolan Vulpix replaces the blue with a pretty purple that accents the white beautifully. It's a nice and understated combination. When Vulpix is exposed to a vibrant Firestone, it evolves into Ninetales. The Fox Pokemon. Ninetales, as its name implies, has nine beautiful golden tails, inspired by the Kyuubi of East Asian folklore. Ninetales is incredibly intelligent and able to understand human speech. Legends say that Ninetales came into being when nine noble saints possessing sacred powers merged into one. And sometimes these are wizards instead. Each of its tails are filled with its own unique mystical energy and allow it to live for 1,000 years. Long-lived Ninetales have shining golden fur and use their supernatural abilities to manipulate fire and burn their prey. Those who cross a Ninetales or yank one of its tails will be cursed for 1,000 years, including their descendants, as Ninetales is a relentlessly vindictive Pokemon. Ninetales can cast a sinister light from its bright red eyes to gain total control over an opponent. opponent's mind, and the fire it spews from its mouth can hypnotize foes before it attacks. That's a pretty badass description. It's no wonder Ninetales is as popular as it is. Foxes are straight up cool animals, so a nine-tailed fire manipulating one is unsurprisingly a sick combination. Even if it's been done a lot in other media, the golden yellow fur is lovely to look at, and there's a beautiful simplicity to its appearance and design. It's very classy looking, and a perfect combination for any canine lovers. One thing that's always bothered me from time to time is the tuft of hair sticking out of its head. It's a little too 80s hairstyle for me, and gives it a different vibe than if it wasn't there. Without it, it would give kind of a cooler Okami-like design, but I suppose it would feel a little lacking if it wasn't there, and it doesn't bother me too much. Regardless, Ninetales is a really cool fire type and a huge Gen 1 fan favorite. Shiny Ninetales is, okay, this is actually really nice. What a perfect coloration to accentuate the spiritual association with the mythical Kyuubi. The indigo tips do a lot to pull the gray body together. It's a beautiful look and definitely one to keep an eye out for. When an Alolan Vulpix is exposed to a frosty ice stone, it evolves into Alolan Ninetales. The Fox Pokemon. Alolan Ninetales has lustrous, bluish-white fur with 9 large, wavy tails. Alolan Ninetales lives atop perpetually snowy mountains. Deities are said to reside in these places, and Alolan Ninetales was even revered and worshipped as one before it was correctly identified as a Ninetales variant. It creates drops of ice in its coat it uses to assail enemies, and often appears draped in a cold blizzard. It's a calm Pokemon, but won't forgive those who disrespect nature, freezing them instantly when angered. These Pokemon also guide people lost in the mountains to the base, because it wants them to hurry up and leave. Wow, that's a really good description. Let's get right to it. Alolan Ninetales is one of my favorite ice-type Pokemon. This is an absolutely magnificent design. It's beautiful, has lovely locks of fur, and a chilly and pristine color palette. This is an amazing variation of Ninetales' design. Its personality also drips through its animations, painting a complete picture of a capable and cool creature. This Pokemon exceptionally represents the beauty of a winter snowfall, and I love it. As solid as the standard Ninetales is, I easily prefer this design, and it's one of the best ice-type designs. Shiny Alolan Ninetales has a lovely purple tint with beautiful magenta eyes. It's a subtle but attractive variation. I prefer the standard coloration, but this gets a solid thumbs up. And that's the Vulpix family. These foxes are all great, and there's one other family of Pokemon with fiery and chilly dispositions. Darumaka. The Zen Charm Pokemon. Darumaka is a small, round, and energetic Pokemon that resembles a traditional Japanese Daruma doll. Daruma dolls are seen as symbols of perseverance and good luck, and they make for quite the encouraging talisman. Darumaka's name comes from Daruma and Maka, the Japanese word for crimson. Darumaka has a constantly burning flame inside its body, allowing it to run around and be energized. When the fire diminishes to the low temperature of 1100 degrees Fahrenheit, it'll instantly fall asleep, pulling its limbs into its body and becoming a sphere. In this state, no matter how it's pushed or moved, it won't fall over when sleeping, and is a popular symbol of good fortune. Darumaka's droppings are hot, so people used to carry them in their clothing to keep warm. Well, the poop thing aside, this is a pretty weird and likable little guy. Darumaka's endearing expression and roly-poly body make for a pretty uplifting partner. I guess he's supposed to be a simian Pokemon, but the monkey-like aspects are pretty subtle, and it feels like a living Daruma doll more than anything. It's a fine design and Pokemon, just not too interesting, but some people are definitely going to attach to his high-energy vibe. Really though, how many fire types are gonna have some kind of internal, constantly burning flame? I get it, it fits them, it's just used a little too much. If you're cold all the time, you can fill your clothes with its shit. Shiny Darumaka is really awful, another lightened version of the regular color palette, and this looks pretty ugly. The pale pink body is not at all flattering. In the scenic region of Galar, Darumaka have white fur, and are known as Galarian Darumaka. The Zen Charm Pokemon. This Darumaka carries a constant frown with shining crystal-like eyebrows and chess pieces. Living in snowy regions for a long time caused Darumaka's fire sack to cool, turning it into an organ for generating cold instead. That's how that works. The colder it gets, the more energetic it'll become. They enjoy playful snowball fights with each other, freezing their breath to create snowballs. Aw, look at it. Even though it's not too different from its fiery variant, Galarian Darumaka is an excellent improvement. The new frowny expression is just too freaking cute, and combining that with its little hands and stubby feet is absolutely adorable. It has a nice color palette, and the eyebrows are a great accent to the design. It's simple and effectively portrays the change from fire to ice. Yeah, between the two, I'd definitely pick the Galarian version. Shiny Galarian Darumaka has a neon face, hands and feet, and it looks kinda like it's caught a cold, which I guess is a cute idea considering the ice type, but I can't say it looks very nice. It's a little sickening. Darumaka evolves into Darmanitan, the blazing Pokemon. Much larger and ape-like, Darmanitan has two huge club-like arms, fiery eyebrows, and a big grin. A special quality of this Pokemon is the ability to transform into a Zen mode when it's been adequately damaged, becoming mentally focused and changing to a dual fire psychic type. Darmanitan's name comes from Dharma, another spelling of Daruma, and Orangutan. Darmanitan's power rises as its temperature does, with its internal fire burning up to 2500 degrees Fahrenheit. When maxed out, this hot-blooded Pokemon's thick arms are strong enough to obliterate a dump truck with a single punch. When it's weakened in battle, it will become still and hardens its body like stone, as if to become a statue. In this Zen mode, Darmanitan meditates to sharpen its mind and spirit, honing its psychic abilities and fighting on mentally. Darmanitan is one of the earliest Gen 5 Pokemon revealed, and he's never really been my type. It's a solid design, a fiery ape with a distinct face, eyebrows, and shape come together to make a very unique Pokemon. It's just a little dopey looking. The fiery eyebrows are the highlight here, but everything is just kind of straightforward and standard. Not bad, just not very interesting. The energetic personality is well suited to its aesthetics at least, and he does have an attractive shade of red. I also appreciate the whole Zen mode thing. It certainly helps to give this Pokemon more going on, but this is not a great design. The eyebrows are gone, it's a bland shade of blue, and it has a lame-looking beak mouth now. Not to mention, it has little personality. A shame, because the lore behind it is cool, but the execution leaves a lot to be desired. Shiny Darmanitan deepens the red to more of a black cherry coloration. It looks nice enough. Zen mode's blue darkens and changes the eyebrows to more of a lavender coloration, and this is actually a big improvement over the standard version. I'm a little impressed. When a Galarian Darumaka is exposed to a frosty ice stone, it evolves into Galarian Darmanitan, the Zen Charm Pokemon. This ice-type Darmanitan is covered in white fur with a huge snowball on its head, giving the impression of a living snowman. Similar to the standard Darmanitan, it also has a Zen mode that activates when angered, this time adopting its lost fire type to become the first and currently only ice fire type Pokemon. Galarian Darmanitan has a gentle disposition, but is also very strong. It can freeze the snowball on its head and use it to headbutt foes. During blizzards, it will wander down from its mountain home to where people live, stashing food it finds in the snowball to take home for later. When made angry, Galarian Darmanitan will enter its Zen mode, reigniting its atrophied flame sac to spew flames and rampage indiscriminately. It won't stop until its anger subsides, even melting its own body in the process. So you want to talk doofy looking? Well, here it is. It's the lips. The giant, weird Santa Claus beard lips. And okay, it's also the giant snowball on its head. I don't know, man. I'm all for more abominable snowman-like creatures, and I do think it's a good iteration of Darmanitan. It's just pretty unappealing, all things considered. At least it's different and unique. Pokemon being unique is always a good thing. The ice crystals are cool, and it has a nicer color palette. The best thing about it is the Galarian Zen mode. Look at this thing. A hopping, manic, fiery snowman is pretty sweet. I always wondered how ice and fire could be combined to create a Pokemon in a way that didn't feel forced. And hilariously, a snowman on fire was not only one of the first images that came to mind, it's what they thought of too. The huge fire spout of a nose is a great idea, and it's overall a very simple and effectively considered design. It's a shame it's only usable when Darmanitan's lost half of its energy. And dang, I really like that smile. Of all four Darmanitan designs, the Galarian Zen mode is surprisingly my favorite. Shiny Galarian Darmanitan has the sick thing going on too, but the green here seems much more subtle and complements the whole look better. I also like the darker colored gems. The shiny Zen mode has some red and purple colors that only increase the volatile and explosive vibe this Pokemon already gives off. That's a solid thumbs up. This thing is growing on me the more I look at it. But now that we're done looking at our two regional families of fire and ice, we're going to take a look at two other Pokemon that fit this theme. Torkoal The coal Pokemon. Torkoal is a coal-fueled, steam-spouting tortoise, and one of the oldest single-stage Pokemon to have never gotten any kind of special form or attention in the games. Torkoal's name comes from tortoise and coal. Torkoal lives in abandoned mines and mountainous regions rich with coal. It digs tirelessly to find some and puts it in the hollow spaces on its shell to burn and create its energy. Homes where Torkoal live are keen to keep flammables around, as it will become unable to move without anything to burn, weakening as its internal flame dies down and even dying if it goes out. When attacked, Torkoal will release a thick black smoke from its nostrils, letting off a sound similar to a locomotive's horn and retreating to safety. Torkoal's wellness is indicated by the smoke spouting from its shell, with a robust, high-velocity smoke cloud indicating good health. Torkoal looks pretty cool. When it has all of its smoke billowing out from it, that is. Most of the time, Torkoal's just kind of a small, plain-looking tortoise, and I guess it's kind of cute, but a little too ordinary. The shell has a nice design, with attractively shaped hollows in it, and the perpetually closed eyes are another nice design element. But it would be a lot more impressive if the smoke was always present. Just look how different an impression it gives off. In this appearance, it really sells the steamy train turtle concept fully. Torkoal's a fine design either way, with a strong visual identity, and I have to admit that the understated appearance does fit its personality. The model in the games makes its smoke kind of an ugly brownish-yellow color, though. It looks bad, like some kind of dust cloud. At least make it gray or black. Shiny Torkoal is a lighter coloration with a red shell, and it doesn't look too great, but I do like the idea of a golden tortoise. A more inspired and striking palette could have really increased its appeal. Ice Q. The Penguin Pokemon. Ice Q is an odd-looking ice-type Pokemon with the distinct ice face ability, hiding its natural noise, or no ice face, under a large block of ice that it constantly recreates to stay cool. Noise. Ice Q's name is a play on the word ice cube. Ice Q drifted through the ocean waters from a frigid place. It's very sensitive to heat, covering its head with ice to stay cool. When the block shatters or melts, it reveals Ice Q's anxious expression, a look that's garnered many enamored fans. The large hair on its head is dangled into the ocean to fish and lure prey for food. This hair connects directly to Ice Q's brain, chilling the surrounding air when Ice Q's in thought. You gotta be kidding me with this design. I love it. Look at him! He's such a little weirdo with his giant head and lumbering, wobbly body. This is one hell of a design. That expression on the ice block says it all. Its hidden noise face is okay. It's a unique expression and bolsters the quirky concept even more, but I'm definitely in it for the ice face. I just can't stop looking at it move around. This is easily one of my favorite ice type Pokemon. I live for weird but endearing creatures, and Ice Q nails all of that. My only gripe would be wanting the noise face to be cuter, but that would be a different kind of idea from the intended concept. I can see some people's complaints about it being overly simple, but I think it's an exceptionally and carefully crafted Pokemon. Shiny Ice Q is also fantastic with a cute bubblegum pink coloration. It's a dramatic change from the standard blue and looks adorable. Ice solid. Well, that was fun. As long as they've been around, the fire and ice types still have so much more room to grow. Pokemon designs are rigorously considered, and there are so many directions you can take with them that new ones are always a treat. Of all the Pokemon we looked at today, Alolan Ninetales and Ice Q will be added to the board of my favorite Pokemon. There are a lot of creatures and concepts you can base Pokemon on, and although you can have two of similar ideas, they can give off radically different vibes and personalities. And as long as that stays true, they're a worthwhile addition. It's important to remember that cute Pokemon are cute, and every Pokemon is someone's favorite. Which of the Pokemon we looked at today is your favorite? Thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe for more Pokemon reviews.